Hello and welcome to Budapest. Today we are going to fly to Venice and we are going to do so in VR. Hopefully this will be a BeyondATC video, but I'm not 100% sure because when I tried to do the microphone test, BeyondATC did not recognize the microphone or my speech at least. So we will see if it works or we are just going to fly ourselves. And this time I'm also using traffic injection from FSLTL. And with that, let's hop into our beautiful, it's too much down, our beautiful HondaJet and start preparing it for the flight. I want to have the checklist on the left side. Okay, a battery is on, oxygen in, pressurization norm, electrical on and norm. Let's use external power for draining the battery. ELT is on norm, nose wheel steering, norm, landing gear lever is, where's the landing gear? Oh, yeah, so landing gear lever is down, the alternate handle that does not work, parking brake is set, flaps are up, thrust levers in idle, even more cutoff position. Speed brake is retracted. Ice protection norm and off. Fuel panel norm. Trim panel norm. Windshield heat panel norm. Pneumatic panel norm. Glare shield panel is dark. No chimes. Okay, before we will start engines, there's a few things we will do. But of course, the passengers are briefed, pedals are adjusted, seats and belts are upright and adjusted, doors closed. We can do that. So, system, some options, yeah, and main door. Doors are closed, parking brake is still set, gas messages, normal ones, electrical was, there should be 30, 23 and a half, we have 29. And we will not yet start the engines because we need a flight plan. So right now we are at Budapest, which is Lima Hotel Bravo Papa. We are flying to Venice, which is Lima India Papa Zulu. And I will need a bit of help for the rest. So, we will fly from 31 left by the Tuzla to Lima departure, so runway 31 left, Tuzla to Lima. Load. We are going to arrive by the Basok 2 Echo, 204 right. Load, and ILS Zulu from LAREM is expected. ILS Zulu from LAREM, and our minimums there is 207. Oh no, we are not going to close it yet because we did not enter the path itself. So Tuzla Kopri. Gemka. Rotar. And then Vasolga. So with that, let's the map on full screen and let's see if it's similar to the one we just made. So Tuzla, Kopri, Gemka, Trotar, Vasok. Yeah, it looks pretty similar, so let's close that one and let's see where we get with Beyond ATC. So let's check the frequencies. /132.38. Okay, Beyond ATC has some kind of an error. I will just try to restart it. Hold on a sec. Okay, I cannot do that, so we will fly ourselves. With that, let's assume that our flight plan is accepted and we are cleared. Let's fly with 1000. Let's move throttle from cutoff to zero. Now it's on zero. Right. Let's start engine number 2 first, so hopefully it's clear. And then to rising, oil pressure rising, internal temperature rising. Engine number 1. Okay, both engines online. We were watching the engine instruments, of course, and the ice will not be needed. It is quite hot outside, it's 26 degrees. External power is disconnected, but cabin power. Is now on. Flight controls. If I remember right, the HondaJet does not have a flight controls page, so let's just do red, the left, right, neutral, down, up, neutral, left, right, speed brakes, and retracted. Let's take off. Anti-ice not needed transponder entered, flight ID confirmed, flight plan entered, navigation sources, GPS, altimeters. That's good call. Let's have Navigraph back for a second. Budapest weather. Oh, 1013, 29.91. Flap set for takeoff, speed brake is retracted. Cabin signs. Seat belts, please. And parking brake released. We will check the brakes, nose wheel steering, and we'll monitor flight instruments. Let's go. I would go away with the pushback thingy. If we don't look at him, he's not going to get hurt. And with that, we already checked the brakes and the nose and steering. Clear left, clear right. I don't need the chart anymore. Let's have a bit of help if there is any incoming. And there is. So, flaps set for takeoff. Trims yet. I remember right, we need about 0. There's the incoming plane. All right, another one. So trims are set for takeoff now. Speed brake is retracted. Cast messages. No cast messages. Navigation is set. Is set, takeoff and landing data, takeoff briefing. Okay, we will not do a proper takeoff briefing this time, we're just going to go for it. After all, we have the luxury of not having engine failure and such in this flight, because they are not set to have one. Interesting. I'm still getting used to the VR headset and the controllers, so excuse me for pushing the wrong button. But back to our stuff to do. So landing gear is up, yaw dampener is on, flaps are up, thrust levers managed by the auto thrust, flight guidance by the autopilot, ice protection not needed, cabin signs will remain on for a little while. Just give ourselves a little view over Hungary, so let's go direct to Kopri. And also, I think we can start climbing. pressurization is happening. 550, 600 now a minute. Altimeters can go standard. Yeah, we are going to fly over Lake Balaton. Not sure we can see it yet. Just a little bit too behind, that's why we are getting this cabin clipping. Yeah, seems better now. There's the Lake Balaton just ahead. And unlike the Longitude, the HondaJet actually has an interior. Above 60. Not bad at all. course, as luck would have it, we have 30 knots of headwind. To meet us. Okay, now that seems like a problem. Level 400. That was close. Of course, if there was ATC, we were told. Hello, I did send the fuel. This makes no sense. I absolutely positively set the fuel. We couldn't have used it all. So, flight level 400. Time to get some speed. And we are half an hour from top of descent. Let's actually ask for navigraph charts back. And see that arrival. So between 12 and 10,000 to 70, we will not be faster than 270. Then Papa Zulu 855 below 9,000 and 230. Stays until Papa Zulu 840. Well, we should still be under flight level 090, but then instead of 230, 210. And the 210 stays until Lorraine, where we are the arrival but on the approach. So Lorraine 4000. Then Kizaf at 3000. Let's make this an at 3000. This is 10995. 5 is correct. And minimum is 207, and it's already set. And should we go missed, proceed on runway heading, which is 039 to 5000. At Papa Zulu 702, turn right 117 and proceed to Papa Zulu 703, then turn right to Akado and hold. Was 3000. Yes. present and in airborne. And we still have 20 minutes to top of descent. Interestingly, somehow this cabin feels bigger than the longitude cabin, which is probably not true. Going to pass 5,000 feet below us, that's not a problem. Pounds of fuel and burning a bit more than 700 pounds so we should be more than fine with this. I don't know how all that fuel disappeared. I guess that was the plane 5,000 feet below us. Let's see if we can take a look at it. It's too far by now. And of course the 45 knots of heaven in this too. my head is not in the cushion but in front of it, so I guess this might be more realistic point of view. And 10 minutes to top of descent.
5.5 miles. And big field elevation.
Should be 0.7.
But
it says 56.
Seven.
Quite a difference.
Vertical track.
P3000 is set. Vina is enabled.
So landing field elevation, there's quite some difference between our charts and what is shown by the system. However, I have no way of altering it, so it will stay as it is. Luckily, cabin pressure is not much of a worry in the simulators. I have no problems with that. Engine anti-ice oil be required when we fly through those clouds. But of course we are way ahead above them.
Interesting, there are some clouds with which we are level. However, them being minus 50 degrees outside, they are hardly made of water, they are made of ice.
Just need to try this. Can I pop my head out? Yep. I can clip through the cabin. Don't try this in the real one.
Okay, that one is far above us. So we will not be in conflict with it. Actually see a lot better through it. there's not much traffic around. So I figured that we will skip part of the arrival. But of course not all of it. Suddenly there is traffic. About 2 minutes.
take the wheel from me. We need to be below flight level 090, not at.
Altimeters 1010.
vertical track.
Someone over there is trying to get ahead of us. Really not nice of them. It's now 14 degrees outside, so let's turn engine on the ice off. And of course, the altimeters are now set for a while. Seats inside passengers, please come inside. Avionics landing with cast messages, approach briefing. There's the traffic. Come on, the approach. And by the way, we are 13 miles out. Off. Yoga banner off. Let's fuel.
Autopilot.
Autopilot off. We are too slow. Luckily, he's going to 0 4.
1,000.
I'm fine with parallel landing to it.
Five hundred. Four hundred. Roll. 300. 200. 100. 50. 30. 10. 5.
I think we will just go and park somewhere over there. Yeah, it says general aviation, so we are going the right way. Thank you. hands parking brake. No parking brake is set, wheel shocks, anti-ice off. External power not needed at this moment. Engine cut off. Again, supply. This can go off, parking brake is set, and battery will go off later. Let's open the door.
So, welcome to Venice. It's not been the prettiest landing of my life. However, I have to say that actually perceiving altitude and depth helps a lot. And I mean a lot when I say a lot. It is day and night difference landing with 3D vision. I hope you enjoyed this flight, and I'm not sure why BeyondATC was not working. I do hope it will do so on the next one. Until then, see you and goodbye.